Okay, thank you so much for joining me today, Akmal.
Thank you so much for coming here.
We're just here today for like a little conversation, a real casual like chit chat. It's kind of like inspired by my song, The Trip.
So in 2015, I was actually diagnosed with breast cancer. And 2015, 16, 17, I was just so focused on treatments that I didn't really, you know, think about my mental health so much. It was very tough to navigate because I had plans for my career, I had plans to start a family, and I couldn't do that. I felt like a burden, thinking like, I don't deserve to be here.
It all started back when I was in let's start with high school. That's where it's more dangerous. At some point when age get older, I felt more cornered to my own small little space. Obviously, that's also comes where self-harming and things I do to cope with this depression, stuff like cutting myself or stabbing myself. It was a heck of a roller coaster. I start thinking the same thought as you had. Whether, what if I never existed? Why am I carrying so much burden? That's where I debate with myself. Whether should I take the leap or should I not?
I started like feeling suicidal at like 7. I took 4 like sheets of like painkillers in just like one go. I was like, okay, I'm doing this. I'm not hoping to wake up tomorrow. I'm just gonna sleep. That was like what I thought, and then like I woke up and I'm like, huh, that didn't work, did it? That was like kind of my first thought. I don't really know the answer of like why I'm still alive, but I guess like it's good.
Being suicidal is not always from zero to suddenly wanting to do it once and for all, right? It starts small. And that's the same for me. Like, I was diagnosed with depression. I have many times thought about, like, would life be better without me? Would the world be better without me? Every now and then I would feel like, you know, I wish someone could just take me away. Like, take me away from this world or from this situation, from this. But it's always there whenever I feel like I'm in a deep, deep trouble or like I'm in a deep hole where it's hard for me to climb up.
At one point, I knew that something was wrong with me. Like I was feeling suicidal, I was thinking about it a lot, and then I wanted like to get help, but my parents, they didn't quite believe in like mental health. They're like, no, my daughter's not crazy, like you're fine, you're just overreacting or you're over emotional. Those kind of things get thrown at you a lot. So at that time I was like, okay, I feel like hopeless because I'm being denied help even though I'm begging for it. So
when people ask me, how does it feel like to be in that position, to be in that dark space, and I just tell them, imagine you're in a very, very deep, dark well, and there are people at the top screaming your name and you can't hear them. And as much as I try to climb out of it, I just keep slipping and I'm just in there on my own and everything is just out of reach. And as much as like my family, my friends, they try their best to be there for me, I'm just like, I don't hear you.
I think subconsciously, I still am pretty excited about life. What is there in life, good or bad, how good it can be or how worse it can be, I think I still would like to see it.
A lot of things go through my mind, but what kept me from taking that one step is mostly about the sadness that my friends going to experience. Might be nothing if I'm gone, but it might be a lot of things when I'm gone for them.
I think 2018, I started going for therapy. And I remember, you know, driving to my therapy session, and every step of the way, I just kept telling myself, you know what, I should just leave. you know what, I don't want to show up. You know what? So it's just that voice in the back of my head telling me, I don't want to do this, I don't want to do this. And yeah, eventually I did. And it was the best decision I ever made, because it's been a while since I've actually thought about taking my own life.
Soon after, I realized how to actually love myself and how to cope with it is by making other people around me feel the joy. I only receive joy not from things I buy or things I'm happy to do. It's mostly from the smiles and the things I do for people. Right. I might put on a mask that I'm a very joyful, cheerful, and then happy-go-lucky. But deep inside, there's times where I'm back in my corner. There's times when I would like to be alone.
Mm. And right now, I'm still like going through like therapy and like trying to seek help and to kind of, I wouldn't say like get over this really, but just kind of manage it better. I think one thing I kind of do is kind of like find the root of it, like what are like the triggers that might push myself into these kind of thoughts, or like when I do have these kind of thoughts, how do I like stop them, or like at least briefly?
I started this habit, you know, recently, I think a month ago, when things were really bad, is to do a gratitude journal. Because everything that I saw was bad about me,
right.
And there's nothing less than hatred and dislike towards myself. And so I felt like, you know, maybe I should do what people have always told me to do, which is just write about whatever that you're thankful for. And I think it's a really good exercise for me, for you, for everyone who's listening, everyone is struggling and thinking about is their life really worth it? Look around and remember all the little things that make you happy in the present. It doesn't matter, like don't think about what used to be and what could happen, just think about what am I happy about right now, what am I thankful about right now, you know?
Honestly speaking, if I did manage to go back time, I'll probably slap the shit out of myself first to wake up, and then probably tell myself I shouldn't be trying to fit in. I shouldn't push myself to wear a mask. I should just embrace myself. Whatever comes next, being yourself will somehow manage to overcome it. Probably that's what I will tell myself.
Okay.
But the slap comes first, There's always a better and more positive way to cope with your depression, suicidal thoughts, etc. Instead of, you know, putting the pain and inflict the negativity towards yourself.
You have a lot more like power in your situations that you realize. Knowing that you have the power to not only validate yourself, to control like your situations, to take charge of it, even if it's in small ways, like, that helps.
Yeah, try to just stay here for one more day. And when tomorrow comes, try to stay for another day. Take one day at a time. Like, don't think about a year, a decade, or the rest of your life. Just take it one day at a time.
Yeah.